Good evening. First tonight, renowned neurosurgeon Charlie Teo may never operate in Australia again after being found guilty of a breach of professional conduct over his treatment of two patients. Dr. Teo had restrictions imposed on his licence after a professional standards review admonished his judgment and even his skill as a surgeon. It left his supporters furious, some labelling it a kangaroo court.
In a podcast released just yesterday, Charlie Teo questioned whether he'd ever operate here again.
Oh, look, I don't know. I'd like to think so, but it might be a bit unrealistic.
But now his fate appears sealed, a professional standards committee finding Teo guilty of unsatisfactory professional conduct and adding his lack of insight into his judgment causes us concern.
But it is a serious finding against him.
The complaints centre around his treatment of two female patients who cannot be named. Both had been diagnosed with late-stage brainstem tumours and given just a short time to live. Both had previously been told their tumours couldn't be operated on, and both patients would die in a vegetative state after Teo performed surgery. The committee finding for one patient, Teo did not exercise appropriate judgment in proceeding to surgical resection. For the other, that the surgical strategy led to unwarranted and excessive removal of normal functional brain.
To see what's happened today has made me ashamed of being Australian.
Charlie Meo's mum, Teresa, was operated on by Teo. He says the neurosurgeon gave them the chance no one else would.
We've got people with ticking time bombs walking in their heads, and we've got a man that gave my mum 6.5 years of life and 11,000 others.
Whether Teo can practice will now hinge on ensuring he has another neurosurgeon sign off on his high-risk cases. But that condition has already been temporarily imposed for almost 2 years now, and he's yet to find one. Dr. Teo has, for the most part, become isolated from the majority of his peers and does not conform to a number of relevant accepted professional standards.
We put our whole lives in the hands of these doctors. We want to make sure that they're experienced, that they're knowledgeable, that they're not taking risks and they're not reckless.
A doctor once heralded internationally as an Australian miracle worker, now isolated and admonished in his home country.
He sends a very strong warning to other doctors. If you step outside the box, if you offer contrary second opinions, then we will get you. Because if we can get Charlie Teo, we can get anyone.
Ursula Hager for 10 News First.